You asked at one point if I had problems because I was a woman. And I have a story to tell, which is I was in high school, and some of the women teachers got together and to have a meeting where girls could ask about, I was already a physicist, so I'm not quite sure where it was. But anyway, girls came and they asked questions. And the teacher asked them questions and so on. It went on for about 3/4 of an hour, and she never asked me a single question. So I said to her afterwards, "Why didn't you ask me a question? Science is a very good thing." And she looked down her nose and said, "Our girls are interested in nurture, not nature." That was a great put there. And so that kind of, those kind of things happen continually. You're in the wrong place if you're, when I was growing up. Now it's no longer the wrong place, since two women got Nobel Prizes this year in science. The truth? We were all Jews. That's the truth. We were 80% Jewish, and Jewish kids study. And Jewish kids know there's a lot of prejudice against them, so they study hard, and it becomes a hobby, a habit. And this is not a thing I want put, the prejudice of Jews towards Jews is that they work hard to get smart. So that's a secret. That's the Jewish secret. We work hard. So please don't tell anybody else that. They won't understand. The gang were a bunch of kids. But maximum of 15 or so, and minimum of 3 or 4 or 5. A bunch of kids who were friends. And were social friends, and they were the people that would be known as geeks to the outside world. Okay? And they were socially not too good, but they were smart, and they never had a friend who was a football player, but they might have somebody who was won a prize in some intellectual thing, and one of my best girlfriends became a justice of one of the highest courts, not the Supreme Court, but the one just under it, after getting a degree in chemistry and in law. Is that the sort of thing they did? And they were just a bunch of friends.